So you might have been wondering, when do I have to use chain rule, and when can I get away with not worrying about it? Well, I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but unfortunately, you always have to use chain rule. Chain rule applies when you're taking both the derivative and the integral, which means chain rule always has to be applied to every derivative and every integral. Now you're probably thinking, wait a minute, I could have sworn that I've taken the derivative or the integral before, and I didn't apply chain rule, and I still got the right answer. Well, you're right, you did get the right answer. But that's because the kind of function you were working with had a very special, very particular kind of inside function. Let's explain what we mean. When we're looking at functions like these ones, these are the inside functions. They're the nested parts of each function. There are two things that make these inside functions special. First, they're linear, or first degree functions, meaning that the highest degree term is x to the first power, which of course is just plain old x. With all of these, the inside function is a linear function because there's no x squared or x cubed, there's just x and maybe a constant here and there. Second, the coefficient on the x in each of these is positive 1, meaning that all of these have an implied positive 1 in front of the x and not some other number other than positive 1. So with those two things in mind, let's talk about what it means to apply chain rule when we take the derivative or the integral. Remember that chain rule tells us that we have to multiply by the derivative of the inside function when we take the derivative, and divide by the derivative of the inside function when we take the integral. In other words, we need to pay attention to the derivative of this inside function. Well, if the inside function is the kind that we're talking about, a linear function with a coefficient of positive 1, then the derivative of the inside function will be 1, which means that when we take the derivative and apply chain rule, we'll be multiplying by 1, and when we take the integral and apply chain rule, we'll be dividing by 1. And multiplying by 1 or dividing by 1 will, of course, never change the value of something. That's why when the inside function is linear with a coefficient of positive 1, it looks like you can get away with taking the derivative or the integral without applying chain rule. But even though applying chain rule to these kinds of functions has no effect on the value of the derivative or the integral, you're still technically applying chain rule. You're just multiplying or dividing by 1 when you do. So remember, regardless of the function, and regardless of whether you're taking the derivative or the integral, you always, always, always have to apply chain rule, even if, in some rare instances, it won't affect your result.
Could you use some extra help with math? Click the button to head over to calculusexpert.com. It's where I've collected and organized all of my best resources, including exclusive videos, notes, quizzes, and even formula sheets. It's the perfect resource whether you're struggling, or if you want to take your learning further, or even if you just want to save yourself some time studying. So check it out, because I know it'll help.